Windows 7 and also in Windows Vista, there are similar ways in which your computers or your computer screen or the desktop is being customized. In this tutorial, we're going to be talking about customizing the background or the wallpaper of your desktop. Now, how do we actually do this? The first thing you have to know is for Windows 7, you can just right click here. The shortest cut to go to is personalize your computer. You can see now also in Windows 7, also in Windows Vista, this also is also applicable, but it actually depends on the particular Windows edition you are using. For Windows 7, the first edition is starter version. You can't actually do this, and in starter version you only have the Windows icon, the Windows logo or background available there, and you can't actually change it. In such a situation, there is nothing you can do to it. But for other versions of Windows 7, like home version, home basic, professional, or ultimate, I personally am using ultimate right now. My computer also came with home basic, and I actually upgraded it to ultimate version. You have to purchase the key to be able to do that. Now, that is the upgrade. Now, for every ultimate, I assume that you are having the ultimate version of this particular Windows. Now, if you want to do that, you either come to this place. For you that is having ultimate, you just click on personalize, then you automatically come into this particular place. To be strictly done, what we have to do is to go to the main control power of your computer system, and that is the control panel. So when you click on your start menu and go to your control panel, you just go to appearance and personalization. Here you are going to see what actually it does. It changes the appearance of the desktop items, apply a theme or screen saver to your computer, and that is where we are going to right now. So you can either click on this or you just click on this. So I want to click on this icon, so you can do any one of your choice. Now, haven't clicked on that particular one that has to do with appearance and personalization. What I'm having here are these particular icons. Some are working on the display and tags bar and all that, and these are what actually we are going to be working with. Now, this is another thing we actually want to do. Now, we want to change the desktop background, which is this, the desktop background. So you just click on desktop background. You can see we've actually come to this place now. If you are making use of Windows 7 Home Basic, or even the other lower edition of it, you can actually it also directs you to this particular place. You can see a whole large number of pictures here. Oh wow, very very beautiful. So you just click on what you want. Immediately you click on what you want, you are going to hear a sound. You can see only one photograph is changed. And by the time you click on each of them and select, that means these things, this particular object or images are going to be switched at a particular time interval. So you just click on there, and these are the numbers you are going to be having. Now let's come to this place. Let's see if I was able to, you see, I was able to work on two groups from different location. By default on other Windows, this is what you are having. You can see this is actually what you are having, which is of this nature. So if you are having something like this for your Windows starter, you can't actually change it. But immediately your Windows operating system is installed, this is what you have. So there is need for you to change it. You have to just come to personalization. But I've actually opened it right now, and this is what I want to do. Now, I want to choose a particular picture. By the time I click on this picture, automatically it is changed. Wow, you see, very, very beautiful. Now, look at the reflection. Now, look at this. By the time I now click on or select different ones. I'm sorry for that. I have to point to this checkbox. Good. Now I now press click on save. I may just tell it to shuffle them. You know, shuffling. Shuffling just means it's not going to select based on the order, but at a different order based on the computer, how the computer wants it. That is shuffling. Now, also, you can tell it, I want you to shuffle this in some number of seconds. If you want it to shuffle them every 10 seconds, you can do it. Now, let me save that now. It has been saved. I can see now. Now, let's see what's going to happen. After 10 seconds, you're going to see this thing. This particular image is going to be switched for another. Just wait. 10 seconds almost here. And on the other hand, if you don't, you can actually change it to your own. You can just right click and just click on next desktop background. But if it is 10 seconds automatically, it is supposed to change by itself. The reason why it will not change is for one reason. Being that if your computer system is not connected to power, that is for a laptop PC. Presently, I'm using my notebook PC right now. Automatically, it's not going to change unless I tell it to do so. You can see I said, when using battery power, pause the slideshow to save power. You can see that means also it is also responsible for what? Power consumption. I just gave you one hint. Won't you thank me for that? Now, look at it. If you want your power to last long, you must be able to tell it to stop every transition that is doing on your desktop. But if I deactivate it now, you are going to see every 10 seconds is going to what? Change it. Let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You see, that's my old count. You can see it has changed it now. Let's count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You see, it has changed again. That's how you continue to change and change and change and change. So as soon as you have your pictures there, just imagine what it will look like. I'm going to show you a very good example of what I am talking about. I'm going to teach you how to customize your own particular picture. Now, I refresh my screen. Okay. Now, let me go back to that customization of my desktop. I love Windows 7 a lot. Now, you can tell it, assume you choose a particular picture, assume it's your picture, and the picture looks somehow blurred. I'm going to apply. Let me apply another format. Let me kind of go and bring pictures from my computer. Now, I want to go and bring some pictures. So, I'll just say browse for picture. I want to do my own animation screen myself for my own desktop screen. I want to go and look for them. I have them somewhere. Okay, all right. Now, these are the pictures I'm having. Now, I want it to only show 1, 2, 3, 4 on my computer. Or let me say this. Now I press every 30 minutes. I want you to always, every 30 seconds, I want you to always switch pictures or shuffle the pictures. Now you can see where I am. You can see that it has covered the whole screen. I can put it, I right click on it and say next background. If you are not using the ultimate version of this window or professional, it can't switch like this. You can see it is somehow bigger than the screen. Now, if you have a very wide screen, now what I want to do now is to click on the particular picture or the picture. I will tell it only center the image based on only its size. So if I click on this, you see it is only centered. You can see black dark around. If you discover that the image is white and other, you can also decide to change it to white. It will look as if it is the whole image, but what? It is just a trick. I can also do that now. Let's do that. Let's see. So I may just decide to say background color. Go to background color and say I want the background to be white. So see what is happening now. You can see. Cute, right? Now remember I told you to center the image. That is why it's only showing just only a very small image. You see, now it looks as if, but this image is very small, it's supposed to be black, dark all around. So you see, that is what you always see when you when you put your pictures inside. Pretty good, nice. You can see, very, very nice. We've done something very, very good. So if you want to make it only one particular photograph, you can decide to say, okay, I want only this photograph on my screen, and I want it to be centered. But if you say, I want you to stretch it, if you say stretch, let's see how it look like. Let's see how it look like. Wow, look, see, somehow blurred. So that is one of the, you have to know the concept that this one work. So you just have to choose the one that is suitable for you to make use of. Let's try tiling. Let's see what tiling is. You can see it has tiled it based on the size and your screen. So if you have a very wide screen, you can have 5, 10, 16 of these particular by based on how small it is, based on the resolution of your particular photograph. So that is what we are seeing right there. So that is how you change your desktop on your screen, on your, as in desktop background. You can see how we changed it now. So for other versions, you gradually come here and try your luck and see if you have it personalized there. If you are having it there, you can change it and personalize how it looks like. So you are going to be doing others. So make sure that you stay with me in the next clip.